But you know, the
why is this not working? I don't even know.
Thank you.
All right, let's come on in. It's time to worship, time to just enter in. Let's worship. We'll be right back. Just turn, look at somebody and say, let joy arise. Don't start the year this new biblical season without joy. Now, tonight it's going to be different. You know, this afternoon there was an impartation that started coming in here and moving. And tonight, any offering you have, just hold it. You know, we're used to just running up and dropping it in anytime we feel led to. But tonight we have an oil or a balm for each one of us, an anointing that God's going to just give you. But then we're going to have an impartation tunnel as we go out of here. So we'll just hold those offerings. We'll just worship. Of course, you can run up and give anytime you want to. I don't care. But at the end, we're all going to be coming up. That's all I'm saying. You can give as much time as you want or anytime you want. But at the end, we're all going to come up and we're going to come under what God has for the year ahead. So let's do it one more time. Turn around and say, let all old cycles begin to break off of us. Shout, this is how we overcome.
When I am weak, you are strong. Though I be poor, you are rich. In the darkness, you are light. No one is like you. Breathing life in the valley, busting down iron gates. You dissolve the chains of death. No one is like you. You are the greatest, you are the mightiest. Lord, you are matchless in your power. You are the holiest, you are the glory, and the lifter of my head. You are the greatest, you are the mightiest. Lord, you are matchless in your power. You are the holiest, you are the glory, and the lifter of my head. Turn my sorrow into joy. Turn my mourning into dancing. When I am weak, you are strong. Though I be poor, you are rich. In the darkness, you are light. No one is like you. Breathing life in the valley, busting down iron gates. You dissolve the chains of death. No one is like you. You are the greatest, you are the mightiest. Lord, you are matchless in your power. You are the holiest, you are the glory, and the lifter of my head. You are the greatest, you are the mightiest. Lord, you are matchless in your power. You are the holiest, you are the glory, and the lifter of my head. Yeah, yeah. Ooh. Yeah, yeah. Oh, 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 oh. Where is the sting of death? And where is the power of the grave? You hold salvation in your hands. Fear and hopelessness cannot stand. Where is the sting of death? And where is the power of the grave? You hold salvation in your hands. Fear and hopelessness cannot stand. Eres más poderoso, inigualable en tu poder. Eres tan santo, eres glorioso, y mi cabeza te levantas. Eres el mejor, el más poderoso, inigualable en tu poder. Eres tan santo, eres glorioso, y mi cabeza tú te mata. Eres el mejor, el más poderoso, inigualable en tu poder. Eres tan santo, eres glorioso, y mi cabeza lo levanta. You are the greatest, you are the mightiest, Lord, you are master in your power. You are the holiest, you are the glory, and the lifter of my head. You are the greatest, you are the mightiest, Lord, you are master in your power. You are the holiest, you are the glory, and the lifter of my head. You turn my morning into day, turn my sorrow into joy. Turn my morning into day, turn my sorrow into joy. Turn my morning into day, turn my sorrow into joy. You are the glory of the lifter of my head. You are the greatest, you are the mightiest, Lord, you are master in your power. You are the holiest, you are the glory, and the lifter of my head. You are the greatest, you are the mightiest, Lord, you are master in your power. You are the holiest, you are the glory, and the lifter of my head.
Now remember, last year was about us breaking forth into a new identity. That should be what we're stepping into right now. Some identity getting loose in us by the Spirit of God that's never gotten loose in us before. Some gift beginning to manifest. Father, we thank you for all we've gone through in the past season, that we might be molded into who we are for this season. Father, we thank you that you are making us into new, sharp, threshing instruments. We will thresh. Say it, we will thresh.
There were diamonds, diamonds, waiting to break out of here.
Look at somebody and say, just break out. Leanne, sing it over us again.
In the weight of every heartache, in the depth of every fear, there were diamonds, diamonds, waiting to break out of here. Those subtle lies, those angry pleas, they're just demons, demons, wishing they were free like you and me. With a light from the sun, with a light when the day is done, we are the brave, we are the chosen ones, with the diamonds, diamonds, rising above the dust.
Oh, all the curses will others. Oh, but you know our name we can see. But these ashes, we're stronger still. You're gonna feel that pain that you feel. You take it down, so many others. Oh, but you know. The sun, we're the light when the day is done. We're the brave, we're the chosen ones. We're the diamonds, diamonds. We're the diamonds, diamonds. We're the diamonds, diamonds. Rising up out the dust.
Fire, and through their paly flames each battle sees the other's umbered face. Not today, O Lord. Oh, not today. Not in this year. We will not back up. We will not surrender ground. We will not go back into the last season. In this year of the Bob, we will strike the gates into our future, into our identity, into this next season. This year, we have entered anew. God, the best maker of all marriages, combine our hearts in one. The body of Christ, this holy body, that our steps might be steady, keeping to the course you have set. Oh, that every part of our lives may remain in line with what you require. And upon our King, in this next year, we will lay our hearts, our lives, our spirits, lay it all upon our King.
And once more into the breach, my friends, once more into the breach. If just 1 ounce of courage remains still within your reach, heaven's champions are watching us now, and deep calls unto thee. So once more into the breach, my friends, once more into the breach. When our arms are too weary, just when we can't catch our breath, Just when we think we can't do it again, we try but there's just nothing left. Bring yourselves up to your full height, you heirs. The line has been drawn in the sand. Stiffen the steel, summon the flood, call up your courage again. Once more into the breach, my friend.
Just put it all across all over the world, breach. On the web. Decree right now that God is calling us back into a new place.
Once more into the breach. If just 1 ounce of courage remains, still within your reach. Heaven's champions are watching us now and see God as a dream. Once more into the breach, my friends. Once more into the breach. Banner bearers, where are the trumpet blasts? Where is the mighty triumphant reserve, the ones who completed the test? Now is no season to lay down your daring. Samuel summons his band. Bring yourself up to your full height, you heirs. Call on your courage. The breach. If just 1 ounce of courage remains, still within your reach. Heaven's champions are watching us now, and He calls us to be. So once more into the breach, my friends. Once more into the breach. And in the night, our sentinels hear the hater whisper his fell plan. To mar our hope, to slight our God, make us accept our chains again.
Shout no!
Us into the breach, we're called there just to stand in that place. It's a place of intercession between God and man, between man and demons, and you stand there interceding until you own that breach and until you can say, Not on my watch will this remain broken.
Not on my watch, Lord. Not on my watch.
Just say it. Say it.
Not on my watch, Lord. Not on my watch. And I will stand. And I will stand. And I will pray. And I will believe. I will proclaim to the breach belongs to me.
Father, in all the brokenness of our past season, Father, we stand now and we ask for that brokenness to be rebuilt. Father, empower us, send lightning from heaven down. Empower us to intercede. Father, allow the fire of your Spirit to rise up within us so that the enemy backs away and what's been captured, we cry, restore. 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 Restore.
Come. In Jesus' name, let them come.
Sing it one more time. Alan, bless the shofar over Iran. And we decree this sound will go from this place in 5776 and shake Iran right now. Shout!
keep silent. We'll make his praise more violent. Proclaim the loving kindness of the King. The sound of praise ascending. Our heads are heaven rending. His kingdom never ending. The heavens.
Father, we cry out. We cry out for the harvest. Father, we cry out that all of the layers of captivity over people groups that have invaded their hearts to capture them, we cry out and we say, this is the time for deliverance.
God, I'm no longer
we'll sing, oh,
don't feel that oneness with the Lord, if you don't feel like you can look at him and say, Lord, thank you that I'm your child. With all my imperfections, I'm yours. You need to just grab hold of somebody next to you and get them to pray with you right now. Don't make this a big effort. Just grab them and say, pray for me. I want to have confidence in my relationship with the Lord.
from my mother's womb. You have chosen me. Love has called my name. I've been born again into your family. Your blood flows through my veins. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God.
Pray with somebody. Thank him for what he's doing in your life. Not where you've been, but where you want to go. Lord, I want to have confidence. Just tell him. You want to know his presence in the season ahead. Now bless two or three people around you. Just bless them. Decree they'll hear God's voice, the voice of the Father, a manifestation of the Son in their life, the Spirit of God speaking to them. That the Word of God will come alive to them this year. If the Word of God's not alive to you right now, just wave your hand. Get somebody to pray for you right now. Just tell them, lay hands on me so that the Spirit of revelation and insight and illumination comes alive in me. Wow. The Spirit of God's here. The Spirit of God's here. Amen. Now you may be seated wherever you are. Wow. Let's just clap our hands. Thank God for what he's doing right now. Wow. It's amazing how the Lord has allowed us to minister to the nations. James, come up here a minute. I want us to thank God for last night. What an incredible, incredible, incredible time. Now extend your hands to James. And Brian, bring one of those new mantles up here. Matter of fact, let's just get settled for a minute. I don't want us to miss this because I think it represents the year ahead. We have key leaders in this house of sound, Judah leading us forth. James Vincent has been going around the world with me, and you know, with that, you receive an international anointing, an anointing to lead the nations in worship. And one of the things I've asked him to do is bring us into a place of international worship here. And last night was probably one of the most incredible nights we've experienced, even though we probably didn't get to the fullness of it, but there will come times where the fullness of the expression of the nations and that which is in our blood will be heard. But I feel like for the season ahead, James, and if John, if you and Leanne are still in here, Justin, Brian, Alan, you come up also. I feel like for the season ahead, you're going to have a new mantle. You're going to have a new anointing. You're going to go into a place that you don't see others go into to blend nations. It's almost it's one of the hardest assignment I've had in the last 20 years is blending the generations and the cultures of worship here. But I know God has a sound in even the Feast of Tabernacles. It says all of the nations that remain that are sheep nations will worship together as one. So somebody, everybody say somebody, has got to step out and get that sound flowing and bring us into not just a place of presentation, but a place of presence with that sound. And I don't know of anybody that did more to press us toward that last night than James. So we're going to put this new mantle on him. And Robin, you stand up also. I see y'all being called to the nations. I see you, your family understanding and your family understanding your call. Pam, stand up. Pam has released me. She released me to go to the nations, not just because she didn't want me at home either, but because you have a call. Not everybody has that call. Robin, come up here with James. She's a prophetess. He's apostolic in what he's doing. And Father, we send them forth to develop something we've not experienced in fullness yet. Father, we say a new glory will come. A new anointing will come. A new authority will come. Father, we release them to go. Lord, we say that they won't be held here, Lord, captive, but they'll be sent from nation to nation. And Lord, their kids will become a troop of those who are called to the nations. Father, we ask you to do something in this whole family that will unlock the sound that America needs for its future and that nations need to align with Israel in days ahead. So, Father, we release them and we say, bring a new anointing and a new authority upon them for the future. New revelation, new alignments, new contacts in Jesus' name.
And Lord, we just declare that they're going to cross-pollinate the nations. Lord, they're going to carry sounds from one nation to another. And Lord, there's going to be a mixing and an intermingling because of these two, Lord God. And we thank you for the sounds and the pollen that they're going to bring back to the house. Lord, and we say there's going to be some new things that are created and formed because you sent them and they were faithful. So Lord, we just say let the Judah mantle rest so strongly and so large upon them, Lord God, and let it be visible. And we ask for open doors and supernatural anointing to go forth as almost as ambassadorial type couple and delegates, even from this house. And we just declare, God, you are paving ways before them. And Lord, we just declare that they will be received to those nations to which that you send them, Lord God. And we thank you, God, for the what is going to come back because they were faithful. We bless them, Lord, and we just say that Judah goes first.
Amen. Now, James, I've told you this before, but the Lord is saying, I am making you a surgeon's scalpel. Both in the prophetic word that you bring and the sound that goes forth from you is going to cut between the soul and the spirit. You can't get into that place without a scalpel, a surgeon's scalpel. But I am putting a sound in you that's going to separate, and it's going to surprise people to see the soul fall off and the spirit begin to come to life and quicken from the dead. Woo!
Wow. Now, before Alan sends them out with a sound, I didn't see this weekend with James. I've seen it for several months, 2 or 3 years, actually. But something happened in Jerusalem while we were there when James and Joseph and I went to the city of David. It was at night. It was Shabbat. There was no one out except several Muslim families were out. And then we went from there, and James said, I said, the Wailing Wall, do you know how to get there? And he said, yeah, from here. And he turned around and looked at Joseph, and he said, it's a slight incline to get there. Now, we're talking about 2 miles uphill. Steep hill. Now, this is me and Joseph. And this is James. Eventually, we got there. And Joseph looked at me and he said, I know why they call this the Wailing Wall now. All I can do is wail because of James. But what God showed me was he's fit to run ahead. And he's fit to move forward. And he's fit to get to a place where he can capture a sound in a way that some of us don't have the breath to capture the sound. And so the Lord says, this is the day and this is the time, and I will begin to order steps in new ways and release anointings in new ways.
I've known James now for several years, and I've always told him he's a human shofar. I can blow my horn every time he begins to sing. That's just how it is, how the Spirit of God works. To send him off, I'm going to ask, if you have a shofar here tonight, I'm going to ask you to stand up right now.
And if you're from another nation, stand up. Because you want to receive gifts from one nation sent to other nations. So you want to resound the sound, and then you want to receive the gift.
So we're going to blow together. If you have a shofar, stand up and get ready to blow it. We're going to blow it together, and for the rest of you, you're going to shout. This will not be a silent place in the next few moments. All right?
Now let's give a shout of victory. Wow. Woo. God's doing things. But I will go ahead and finish that story at the end when we got off the plane, when we got back to Philadelphia. I said, now, James, you've got to take care of Joseph to get him through the line because I have TSA and I wasn't going to wait on him. As a matter of fact, I've tried to get rid of him for the last 40 years, but I just said, I got to go one way and y'all, you take him and go the other way. I told him that before we got off the plane. When we got off the plane, we were moving forward, and of course, I took the escalator, and Joseph got to the bottom of the escalator. There goes James bouncing up four flights of stairs. Joseph said, I'll go back to Jerusalem. So again, I couldn't even get Joseph pawned off on James. Now, this is a wonderful night. I see people at the back. What are you doing? Let's go. Let's do something. What's happening? Oh. Is that John Dixon?
Scotland and England and Wales, and we brought back for the booty, we brought your plaid, and it's the Pierce plaid, and it's from Ireland. You're connected to the throne of Ireland.
When we were in Scotland, the gentleman told us that the Pierce tartan was from Tara, which is the kingdom of Tara. And I just want to give the people here a little bit of the history of that. And the hill of Tara was once an ancient seat of the power in Ireland. 142 kings are said to have reigned there. 142 kings. And you have a kingly anointing upon you. One interpretation of the name Tara says that it means a place of great prospect. You know what? This place is a place of great prospect. Great prospect. St. Patrick is believed to have lit the first Paschal fire on the Hill of Slane, which you can see from Tara. He did this in AD 433, defying the pagan High King of the day that resided in Tara. The king had issued an edict forbidding the lighting of any other fires within the site of Tara. And according to a biography of Patrick written in the 7th century, the king, who was known as a fierce and a pagan king, gave his life to the Lord because of Patrick's defiance in lighting that fire. And I came in late this afternoon. I wasn't here for yesterday and the day before, but when I came into this place, the fire of God was in this house. And I believe God is saying to us in these days, we've got to light some Paschal fires. You have been going through the nations lighting Paschal fires. Lighting a fire. And it's all to do with your heritage. It's all to do with who you are. It's all to do with your DNA. And I was woken this morning on the aeroplane and was given a word. And I want to share it because it fits in perfectly with what Jenny was talking about. And Steve, I thought, Steve has stolen my word. And the word I received on the airplane said, the Lord is saying to us, I want to unlock and release the sound of the Celts once again, to unlock the fires of revival throughout the nations, those carriers of fire, those burning ones. I want to unlock perseverance, tenacity, a spirit that refuses to give up. You have this, Chuck, because it's in your DNA. A fearless one, a committed one, the loyal ones. I want to unlock the protectors of my word, the selfless ones, those who are not ashamed of me or my word, ones who will stand for the truth. Warriors, arise. Brave hearts, arise. The time has come for your true identity to be released. Release the battle cry. Run to join the ranks. Run to the battle, for victory is yours. Possess your destiny. Possess your identity. It's yours for the taking. So step into me and step into your place. It's time. So this incoming year, the Lord is saying it's time to light the fire, not only from this house, but from your houses. Light the paschal fires that the enemy will see you burn. And Chuck, the Lord give me a word. And I read this last week and I automatically thought of you. The enemy whispers to the warrior, you cannot withstand this storm. And the warrior answers, I am the storm. Woo! Hey! Woo! Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. I love that line. I love it. May the DNA of the Irish that's within you awaken this year to a greater measure. You're a man who knows the intricate workings of time, one who carries the timing of the Lord and releases it in the right season and at the right time. And I got this pocket watch for you from Ireland. And I've asked the Lord that it would be a reminder of the Celtic sound that's within you, the one of the warrior who runs to the battle and calls others to war. To possess our inheritance, we must be ready for war. Courage and kindness. And you know, you possess that. Courage and great kindness. And knowing who you really are can change everything around us. A higher dimension awaits this year, Chuck. And finally, you'll light paschal fires throughout the nations as you walk in the anointing of the warrior he has called you to be, because you are the storm. Wow. Amen.
This is the first time since we've begun gathering that we had representatives from all of the British Isles.
Amazing. Before you lead us out with that incredible sound, this, I don't think this could have happened before 2 weeks ago. I think I had to go through something that was very important for me to go through that I'm not really free to share at this point with you. But the Pierce portion of my life I've never denied. I've embraced, I've loved, even though of all the reproach that came on it through the years. The Lord has had me on a journey of 40 years removing that reproach. 40 plus years now. And it wasn't until just 2 weeks ago that a final hidden measure of it left. And I knew then no longer was the Pierce heritage. My other portion of my heritage is the LeGrand heritage, which married into the Chickasaw Nation. And I knew no longer was that to ever be submerged again, and that a new generation would rise up and carry forth that heritage. I believe it started happening when Isaac and Celestine had their child. It represented the 10th child, grandchild. And I want to say to you, it's a great heritage. And within you are great heritages that you've subdued because of things that have happened in your life. The Lord wants the best that He had in your bloodline unlocked. I believe tonight from this group, they have mantled me, which I'm always mantling people all over the world. They've mantled me with one of the best portions that I could receive from my identity. Let's thank God for what He's doing in restoration.
Y'all, we're going to do something, one more thing real quick. Ann, will you come back up here, please? We were standing down there when they were doing this presentation, and I had no idea what it was going to be. And last year, Chuck took me and Ann and a group of us to Ireland. First time I had been on a trip like that, and it was quite an experience. But while I was there, I got a song. I wrote a song, and I showed it to some people, and I showed it to Chuck, and it just wasn't the time for it. And I thought, well, I don't know what that's for, but there it is. And I just realized standing down there, showed it to Leanne, I think this song is for you. So I'm just going to sing a little bit of it. So, gather where you've been scattered, part the waters, cross the seas, link your arms where hearts are tattered, and rise in one identity. The ancient sounds of sorrow flee, drowned out by songs of victory. My winds will rise if you'll believe, the time is now for destiny. My song will rise over walls of stone, on hills of green where seeds are sown. So raise your voice, ready to run. It's time to fight for the souls of your sons.
Wow. Turn and tell somebody it's time to go to war. Wow. And with you standing up, let's welcome Trevor and Sharon Baker to come up and say hello and bless us and impart to us. Wow. Listen to that sound. Let your bloodline come alive.
Thank you, Lord. It really is a joy to be here with you again, Chuck. Thank you so much for inviting us. The Lord's been speaking to me from Psalm 18, which came out this morning as well. He set my feet in a secure place on the heights. And Trevor and I just want to say a huge thank you that you have helped set our feet in a secure place. And you have being behind us, advancing us, making sure we go up higher and further. And is that the same for so many of us here? We just want to say thank you because you have helped make us secure. And I just know that in this time, in this year of being set in secure places, God is saying, I haven't given you a spirit of fear, but I've given you a spirit of power and of love and a sound mind. And that will help us, that will aid us, that will push us forward in being set in a secure place. Thank you. Thank you, Chuck.
Wow. And Chuck, we were in France in the summer. And I was in this one store, and the Lord told me to pick up a key. And this is the key that he asked me to pick up and to bring here and give it to you for this evening. And as I do that, I believe that there's something that God is wanting also to do. And that is on the 19th of October in 1781, there was a man by the name of Cornwallis who was kept secure in the city of Chesapeake, waiting for other forces to come and join him so that he could put down what was being called the rebellion of the colonies. And what happened was the French joined with the Americans and were able to cause him to surrender all his troops. And God says that there was a connection in the natural, but God says that there is a connection in the spirit realm. And in the spirit realm, God says that you are going to bring people into a place of freedom and into a place of independence where the enemy no longer holds control over their lives, and they will move forward into all that God has. And God says tonight, Chuck, he says that there were those who were the principal gatekeepers. God says that you are one of those principal gatekeepers. And it says, and they would spend the night stationed around the house of God because they had guard of it and they had charge of the key, because they were responsible for the treasury rooms of the house of God. God says that I have caused you to be in a place where you now are one of those that have access to the treasury rooms of the heavenly realm, where you will release and unlock resources into this realm. And God says, and in this place, there will be such a resource of the supernatural resources of God, in order that all that you have in your heart to fulfill will be fulfilled, and it will bring freedom and liberation to those that connect with you. And also, that was 234 years ago. And the Lord told me, and he says, go to Jeremiah 24. Let me just get it. Jeremiah 23. And it says, and I will place shepherds over them who will tend them, and they will no longer be afraid or terrified, nor will any be missing, declares the Lord. The days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will raise up to David's righteous branch a king who will reign wisely and do justly in the right and right in the land. In his days, Judah will be saved. Israel will live safely. This is the name by which he will be called, the Lord, our righteousness. And I release that over you as I give you this key tonight, Chuck. Amen. Come on, raise a shout. Woo! You know, I believe that we just entered into some things, but tonight's going to be a good night. Amen. Now, I mean, tonight is going to be a good, good night. I say tonight's going to be a good, good, good night. Amen. Are you ready? Are you ready tonight for the Josephs to arise? I believe tonight is a night when Josephs are going to arise. Tonight is going to be a night where God is going to do things in your life. Tonight, you're going to leave behind the prison. You're going to leave behind the pit. You're going to leave behind the clothes that you wore in the last season. And you're going to come into a new season. Hallelujah! It's time for the Josephs to arise. God has got mantles of anointing to place upon your life tonight. See, tonight you are going to be set free from the fowler's snare. Hallelujah. What the enemy tried to catch you in, he's going to be caught in it himself. Go on, give God praise. This is your night. This is your night. This is your good night. Hallelujah. Hey, listen, tonight you're going to get a new portion. And the new portion is for you to rule over a greater dimension of the realm of the Spirit and in the geographical places that He has put you in. Amen. See, I believe that just like there are geographical locations on the earth, there is also geographical locations in the realm of the Spirit and in those heavenly realms. God wants you to access those things. Hallelujah. God wants you, as we sung last night, He wants you to live a life of favor. I know who I am. Do you know who you are? Turn to the person next to you and say, do you know who you are? See, tonight you're going to get access to new resources. I believe tonight you're going to receive a new key that will unlock the new portion that God has for your life. Hallelujah. I'm excited, aren't you? Shavaravasa. Hey! Whoa! We want to take the hey into the next season. We don't want to leave it behind. Because we want to keep stirring up the winds of the Spirit of God, don't we? Oh, hallelujah. Shoborobakabasa. I've got some notes that's only to keep me on track. That's all that's for. See, so tonight, we're going to step into some new things. See, what the enemy tried to keep you away from, what the enemy tried to take from you, what the enemy tried to do to make you small, God says, I am going to anoint you afresh tonight with an anointing that breaks every yoke that the enemy has put upon you so that you get access to resources. Listen, that's what the kingdom of God needs on the earth. We need to have access to those heavenly resources that translate into all that we need in this realm. Amen? And that's what God's got for you tonight. It says in Psalm 105, it talks about Joseph, and that's what I want to just cause things to be built around for this evening as we come to release you into what I believe is picking up all the anointings that you've had in the past that were taken from you, the mantles that you received in the past that the enemy took off you. You're going to pick all those up tonight. Hallelujah. And not only that, God is going to release a new mantle on you. And in that releasing of the new, He will begin to elevate you and He will begin to promote you into your new sphere of influence and territory. Give God praise tonight. Oh, you can do better than that. Hallelujah. And it says here, He called down a famine. That's God called down a famine. Because God can do anything to get his purposes and his people in the right place. That's all it's for. And it says he called down a famine and destroyed all their supplies. But he sent a man before them. Joseph, sold as a slave. They bruised his feet with shackles. Anybody got bruises tonight? Let me tell you, there is balm in Gilead tonight. There is healing anointing in Gilead tonight from every wound of the enemy, so that you can step into what God has for you, and you can leave behind the prison, and you can move into the blessing that God has for you. Amen. And it says here, his feet was put in shackles, his neck was put in irons, till what he foretold came to pass. Let me tell you, every word that God has spoken over your life will be fulfilled. Every promise that he's spoken, it will come to pass in your life. And there is no question about that. Is all we need to do is to press in to what God has for our lives tonight. And just to move and see God dealing with us in our hearts so that we can move into new places. Let me tell you, the cross always has to be evident in our lives if we're to move into a new level. See, for Jesus to move into resurrection power, he had to go through the cross. He had to go through the grave. But going to the cross, going through the grave, he rose in a new dimension of power. And he became the firstborn from amongst the dead. There was no one else who'd ever done that before until Jesus comes, the one who was never going to die again. Hallelujah. Oh, he was walking in favor. He knew what it was to walk in favor with God and with man. And he knew who he was. Do you know who you are tonight? You know, we sing, I am a child of God. Do you know who you are tonight? When you look in the mirror, do you know who you are? Do you know who's looking back at you? Oh, wow. Shabarabasa. Hey. Oh. See, tonight you're going to get a new portion. And let me tell you, you're the one that determines how big the portion is. Are you hungry? Hey! Whoa! I told you, we're going to have a good night. A good night. Hallelujah. And so here, you know, there's just some things here from Genesis that I just want us to look at. Let me tell you, it was 13 years from the time that he started receiving prophetic revelation, got favor on his life, until the time that he stepped into Pharaoh's palace. 13 years went by. 13 years went by, and not only that, but two mantles of favor that was put on his life were taken off until God got him to the place that he wanted him to be. See, God has a purpose in all of those things. And we never want to let go of the power of the working of the cross. It's foolishness to men, but it is the wisdom and it is the power of God for our salvation. Amen? To us who are being saved. I was in a restaurant just a few weeks ago and the woman came up to serve me and I said to her, so tell me, do you have a dream? And she says, I said, what dreams do you have for your life? And she said, I don't really have any dreams. She says, I'm working 3 jobs just to make ends meet. And I just said to her, and I said, well, you know, if God were to give to you, offer you tonight, today, eternal life, what would you do? She said, I'd take it. I said, well, give me your hand. She gave me a hand. And I just led her in that salvation prayer. And then I connected her with the local pastor. See, people are longing for good news. Do you know that? And hear this whole story. This whole story is about good news. See, no matter what the enemy may try and tell you, God has got good news for you. Do you understand that? And here, he was 17 years old. He got a garment. He got favor from his father. Let me tell you, this is what favor will do. Favor is when somebody is well disposed towards you. When somebody wants to grace and gift you with something, that's when you come into a place of favor. Not because of anything that you've done, but because they intend to bless you. Hallelujah. And so his father made him this coat of colors. And it says it was richly ornamented robe. And his brothers saw that the father loved him more than any of them, and they hated him all the more. Listen, if you're going to move into all that God has, jealousy must be dealt with. Do you understand? And listen, we can only deal with jealousy at the cross. See, the cross cuts across every cord of self-interest in our lives. I used to be at the Bible College of Wales with Rhys Howell, and particularly his son Samuel Howell, and he would say to us, intercession is the knife that cuts across all the cords of self-interest. Because what it does, goes to the right to the heart of what is taking place in our lives. And so here his brothers saw that he was more favored than them. How do you look at people who also are favored? See, something done out of an act of kindness, that's favor. See, it's the goodness and the kindness of God that leads us to a place of repentance. Do you understand? We want to take all these truths with us. As God moves us to a place where he's going to release a greater anointing upon our lives, we have to take these things with us. And so here in this place, what does it do? It positions you. Favor will position you for it to a new place of approval. Hallelujah. Don't you want to know the approval of God over your life? It says of Jesus, "This is my son. With him I am well pleased." That was a declaration that he was making to all those standing around. And then he says in Luke's gospel, "You are my son, in whom I'm well pleased." See, Papa was looking at his boy and saying, "That's my boy, and I'm pleased." And he didn't do anything up to that point. Can you see? That's favor. When you get to that place, you can say, "I live a life of favor. I know who I am." Hallelujah. And so here with his life, in this place of favor, what does it do? It will position you for preferential treatment. Hallelujah. Don't you want preferential treatment? Huh? Oh, that's what favor will do. And listen, you can grow in favor. See, favor is not something. See, God's acceptance, his love is, and his acceptance is for every one of us, and it's all the same. But you can grow in favor. You can grow in favor with God and with man. There's a twofold aspect to it. Hallelujah. Oh, I love this God, don't you? Oh. And you know what? He loves you and me too. I mean, he really does. Sometimes we think, because of what we go through, "God, what are you doing? What are you putting me through all this?" And he says, "Because I'm working some things out of your life, that unless they are worked out, you won't be able to carry the new anointing that I want to put upon you." See, don't you want a new mantle of anointing tonight? See, what does grace do, or favor do? It positions you so that you move into a place of advantage. Hallelujah. See, you get to have advantage over the enemy. See, God positioned you in favor so that you come up above all of his activities, all his strategies, that you are able to gain the advantage. And in gaining the advantage, you push forward, because we're not moving back, are we? Are you going to move back, or are you going to shimmer, shimmer? Huh? Hey, come on. And so here. But favor will move you to a place of promotion where you have an audience with the king. Come on. That's what favor does. And listen, when God mantles you tonight with a new mantle of anointing, of authority, let me tell you this, you're going to move to a new place where you have audience with the king. He will speak to you so clearly. Amen? That's what we're wanting. We're wanting to hear God's voice. And we don't need him to shout to us even the slightest whispers, because he has lifted us up in his favor. And as he lifts us up, we get to hear him speaking to us. Hallelujah. Whoa. Woo. And so you know what happened. His brothers were jealous of him and they took his garment that represented the favor of his father upon his life. They took it, and then what happened? They threw him into a pit, and they then killed an animal, took it back to his father, and then the whole story was that Joseph's dead, and this is the garment that you gave him. Listen, that's what jealousy will do. We heard it the other night. See, if you're jealous with the people down the road, if you're jealous with someone else who is involved in ministry, let me tell you this. It will rob you, not them, it will rob you of the favor that God wants to put upon you. And you will enter into a place of famine, not them. See, so we have to deal with those things in our lives, but also in the life of Joseph, is what's happening. I mean, this was a 17-year-old young guy who was full of himself. I have a dream. But before that, you see, he'd already got favor, but he was telling all the bad stories about his brothers. Gossiping. Tale-bearing. Causing displeasure to come on his brothers. Little wonder they wanted to get rid of him. See, it wasn't just what they were doing, it's what he was doing. I had a dream of she's. Listen, I believe that dream of the she's was speaking to his destiny. When they would all bring she's to him, and he would be administrating the resources to the whole of the nation. And he was saying, but yours, guys, you bow down to me. And not only that, I had another dream. I had a dream of the stars in the sky and the sun in the moon. And mom and dad are going to bow down to me too. That's not good news to people who are jealous of you. You understand? I mean, that will wind them up. That will cause them to gnash their teeth. How can we get rid of this person? Do you understand? And you just seem to breeze to, hey, do you like the coat I got? You know? Dad gave it me. Favor. In fact, I think I'm more favored than you. Oh. Can you see? And with Joseph, God had to deal with self-promotion. See, that's what was taking place. And so he gets favor on his life from his father, But his brothers take it off him because of jealousy. And God needed to deal with his self-promotion. Because for what God had for him in the future, that needed to be dealt with. And so here he goes down into this pit. And in the pit, everything is taken from him and he's sold as a slave. And as he comes into Potiphar's house, what happens there? He got favor again. See, listen, when God wants to favor you, he will find people who will continually put favor on you because of what you're carrying. Do you understand? I can remember when I got born again some years ago now, and I was at a rehabilitation center. I'd just come out of prison, and now you know, and that explains a lot of things. And I'd just come out of prison, but see, I prayed when I was in prison. You know, did you know that they say 90% of the people who are in prison have never committed the crime they're charged with? That's what they say. That's what they say. I was guilty on all accounts. And if they'd have found out all the other stuff that I'd done, I would have been a lot longer. And but I prayed this one night and I said, God, if you get me out of this place, I'll go to this rehabilitation center. Within half an hour, I'd been released from the prison. I thought, now that's a powerful prayer. You know? And listen, and I wasn't even a believer. Wow. And I went to this center and I was there 2 days before I became a Christian because the favor of God was coming upon my life. And when people came into the center, I mean, I just wanted them to get what I got. See, I wanted them to come under the blessing that I'd been under. So I was leading these people to Christ, getting them delivered. I mean, I was speaking in tongues, I think, within about 3 days. So they were coming in, withdrawing from heroin. I was saying, so all you have to do is get born again, speak in tongues, and you're okay. You know? I mean, it worked. You know, somebody once tried to pray a spirit of addiction out of me. And I said, but I don't have one. They said, well, we think you do. And I said, well, okay, if you think I do, then you pray it. But I knew I didn't. Do you understand? You can't pray something out of somebody if they haven't got it. When I became a Christian, I became a Christian. I became a new creation. Old things got passed away. All things become new. I believed it. That's all. And I was leading all these people to Christ. And I was feeling really good about it. Until the director of the center called me to his office. And I mean, I thought I was going to get, you know, a really good pat on the back. You know, you led all these people to Jesus and, you know, it's wonderful what you're doing. You're getting them delivered from their addiction by getting them praying in tongues. And so he said, I've heard that you've been leading people to Christ. I said, yes. I said, just this last week, I said, I think there's 12 people I've led to the Lord. And they're all speaking in tongues as well. And he says, well, listen here, you. And he was going to give me a PowerPoint presentation. And it was going over my head. And he said, listen here, you. I'm thinking, oh no, this doesn't seem like favor. And he says, I'm the one who leads people to Christ, not you. I'm the one that gets them baptized in the Holy Spirit, not you. He says, so you stop doing this now. I rebelled. And see, they can try and take it off you, but you see what happened. Instead of doing it, you know, in this big drawing room, I had to go into a little cupboard. So I would sneak people into the cupboard and get them born again. And I'd say, don't tell them. See, don't tell them what's happened or who did it, you know. If anybody asks you, tell them it was the director, you know. See, they can't take it off you. And Joseph, when he went to Potiphar's house, he still had favor on his life. And what he had there was a greater entrustment. It wasn't taken away. He was given more. And now the issue was him holding someone else's entrustment. Do you understand? It wasn't about his prophetic gifting. It wasn't about his revelation. That got him into the pit. He gets out of the pit, and what now comes on him is another favor, but the favor is to bring him into a place of increase. Hallelujah. And now, the increase that he gets, he's now entrusted with everything that's in Potiphar's house. Isn't that amazing? And so here he is in Potiphar's house, and it says he was a handsome young man. That meant that there were women that were after him. And what happens here, he comes into this place. When he's there, listen to what it says. Joseph found favor in his eyes because his attendant Potiphar put him in charge of his household and he entrusted to his care everything that he owned. Listen, if you can't do it with somebody else's goods, you will never do it when God gives you your own. And so here, what he was having to deal with in this situation was how he was going to handle other people's things, other people's stuff. And you see, as he was doing that, if he was dealing with other people's jealousy, here he was dealing with other people's accusations. Because it's not very long when you're moving into things that the enemy comes with accusations. And the enemy accused him. And as he accuses him, is what happens, that which he had, his mantle of identity, was now taken from him. But you see, when you have favor on your life, I live a life of favor. I know who I am. Hallelujah. Do you understand? See, do you know who you are? See, you get to know who you are when the favor of God is upon your life. And so here with Potiphar, it increases. He gets to steward other things. And in the stewardship is what happens. Accusation comes and he's taken out of that place yet again. And from there, he moves into a place where he's put into the prison. And in the prison, you see, even in the darkest place, it says, and God was with him. Hallelujah. There will never be a place where you get to that God's not with you. But you see, what's happening is the cross is working in his life. It's getting rid of the areas that he has to deal with. It's getting rid of his self-promotion. It's getting rid of his self-righteousness. That's a biggie for some. We think that we're getting all of this because of what we've got. And yet it's because of what God wants to give us. And so here with the accusation comes against him, God deals with his self-righteousness. And the cross again is working in his life. You see, it's never a straight road, is it? We keep bumping into this thing called the cross. And we've seen it over the last few days of being the Vav. And the way that it was put was a cross, with a peg and a T. And we keep bumping into it. Why? Because God wants to deal with our hearts. Because he has more for us. And here, as he comes into this place, and as you're coming into a greater place, you see, here he was dealing with things, but God wanted him to know how to deal with people. And in this place of accusation, he's put into prison. And in prison, he could have easily withheld the grace and the favor gifts that he's got. But what happens is in prison, and the baker comes, and then the butler comes, and he gets a very favorable response. You know, when you hear somebody getting favorable responses, when you're after a prophetic word and you hear somebody getting a great prophetic word, be careful when you go for yours. And he says, I see you, and you have a cup, and you're going to lift the cup back up into the hand of the king. And within 3 days, that's going to happen. 3 days, he's gone. The baker says, hey, what about me? I got a basket on my head. I know I'm a baker, but it's okay. I'm only a baker by name. In fact, just recently I found out that our name is not Baker. Our family name was Bach, as in Johann Sebastian Bach. And in 1728... the names of our family were Ori, Levi, Benjamin, Levi. And they came to England, and then they changed their name from Baker to Bach, but they still kept the first names of Ori, Levi, Benjamin, Joseph, right up until my grandfather, whose name was Ori. And so all of these things, I just found that out. You see, the enemy can try and take everything from you, but God wants to give you everything back. Do you understand? And here, he comes to this place. And in this place, the favor of God is upon him, because God is preparing him to bring the resources to the nations. Do you understand? God wants the Josephs to arise. God wants the Josephs to come out of the prison. And so when he speaks to the baker that says that the birds of the air came and took it. See, I believe it's more to do with God's word and allowing the enemy to come and take the word away from our lives. And he didn't protect an entrustment that he had received. And the butler, he comes and he brings the wine back into. Let me tell you, I believe that God is looking for people who will carry the new wine and bring the new wine into the presence of others so that they can drink the new wine, so that they can become so intoxicated with God. Do you know what happens when people get drunk in the new wine? Well, the same as what they get drunk with wine. People who get drunk with wine, they talk differently. They walk differently. Have you seen people leave in some meetings? And they're ready to take on the world. See, we need to get drunk with the new wine. Do you understand? You need to get drunk with the new wine. You need to get so drunk with the new wine that you're ready for the world, so that you can go and bring what God has for the nations. See, I believe that God is wanting to pour out the new wine all over again. And I believe that God wants us to move to that place. And here, while he's in prison, these are the things that are taking place there. As he comes into the prison, he has to deal with now abandonment and forgetfulness. He is forgotten in using his gift to bless others. And all he says to him is, will you remember me? Will you remember my face? Will you remember who I am when you come into the presence of Pharaoh? Because I am put here wrongfully. Would you speak on my behalf? And he forgets all about it. See, there are those times when we have to deal with those areas of abandonment that go deep into our hearts. Because God needs to get you to a place where he wants to put your face into your frame. He wants to get your face into your frame so that other people see what God has done for you. What God has put in your life, the image that you carry. Did you know that you are an image bearer? Did you know that when God created the heavens and the earth was without form and void, darkness covered the face of the deep. Did you know that everything has a face? And the enemy wants to deface us. The enemy wants to take from us who we are. Tries to make us something that we're not. Winston Churchill once said these words, God has made you an original. Never try and be a copy. Do you understand? And so often God has to remove. See, the enemy puts a face on us. He covers that over so that we can't be seen. And when we're not seen, we have to deal with those things. We're always trying to be someone else. And God wants us to be ourselves. And God, what does He do? When He's created everything, He then says, now let us make man in our image. In the image of God made He them, male and female made He them, and He blessed them, and He says, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth, and subdue it, and rule over. And then He gives them the jurisdiction of what He's going to rule over. See, what's He doing? See, God has created this glorious place called the earth. And in that place, He wants to put Himself. You see, and you look at all the temples. We go to India and I see it all the time. There's idols and there's gods and there's shrines. There's everything. And what do? They form an idol, which is in the image of their God. And they put the idol into the temple or they sit it on the shrine. What are they doing? They're just getting a representative of their God into what they call their temple. When God creates all this, He says, I want to come and I want to be part of what I've made. So what does He do? He creates man in His image and He places man here. And He places man here so that we get to be image bearers. Hallelujah. And in that place of image bearing, we get to have the greatest privilege of all, and that is to be a blessing. Did you know it's so hard to be a blessing? Did you know that? See, God wants us to be a blessing. And Adam failed. Not only that, He wanted Abraham to be a blessing. And He says, Abraham, if you leave your mother and father, if you leave your house, if you leave your people and your country, go to the place I will show you, I will bless you. And you will be a blessing. And any nation that blesses you, I will bless. Do you know the first thing that Abraham did? This is our father, Papa Abraham. The first thing that he does, he curses Abimelech by lying to him. I told you it's hard to be a blessing. And what happens instead of a blessing is he ends up causing all the women to be barren until he gets to pray for them and remove the curse off them, and then he releases blessing back into them. See, God wants you and me to be image bearers. And with Joseph, He was getting him to a place where he could have his image put into Pharaoh's palace. And in Pharaoh's palace, he was going to be a blessing. And not only that, this time when he gets given a mantle of anointing, when he gets given a mantle of favor, they never take it away from him again. Hallelujah. Do you understand? See, I believe tonight you're going to get a mantle of anointing upon your life. And when you get that upon your life, nobody will take it off you. Do you know why? Because you've allowed the cross of Jesus to deal with the places that you've been over the journey that you've been on. See, there's a wonderful thing about 13. 13 is this, that it's 1 year after the 12. And that means that here, 12 for me always represents governmental apostolic authority. And so he's moved through these and he's come to this place where he's moved into a place where now he has governmental apostolic authority to deal with the entrustment that God is about to release to him. Which wasn't just a few little bits of stuff. God was going to give him enough in order that a nation could be saved. He was going to give to him the ability to rule nations. But you see, he needed to know Mark 16 working in his own life first. Knowing that God was bringing him into a place of salvation. And once that had taken place, he could now bring him into a place where he can now disciple nations. Do you understand? And there's people here, and you don't know why you've gone through some of the things that you've gone through. It's so that you can be a blessing in the nations. See, God is going to cause Josephs to arise. Are there any Josephs here tonight? See, it's time for the Josephs to arise. It's time for the Josephs to step into their place. God wants you to step into a new place tonight. And in that new place, he wants to put a new mantle upon you so that he can get heaven's resources to you. Let me finish with this tonight. This is what I mean. God is going to begin to cause the angelic realm to break in an incredible way. And as it breaks in, there's going to be resources that you get to handle. I believe this place is going to be a place of resource for the nations. And I was in Anacortes, just up in Washington State, a number of years ago. And I was in an undertaker, staying with an undertaker. Undertaker said to me, he said, you know, Trevor, people look down on us undertakers. He says, but you know, one day everybody looks up to us. And I was in his, staying there, 5 o'clock in the morning, an angel visits me. And when I see angels, they're like translucent forms of light. That's how I see them. And this angel was probably between 20 or 30 feet, standing where the wall was, but there was no wall around it. And the angel spoke to me. And as the angel spoke, I was in what I could only call was one of heaven's map rooms. And there was all these maps in these little pigeonholes. And I was asked to take a map out of that area, out of one of these holes. And I pulled out an atlas. I suppose if you're going to pull out a nation, you may as well take the whole lot. So I took out this atlas, and I didn't know it was that when I pulled it out. I laid it on the ground. As I'm laying it on the ground, the angel then says, now cup your hands. And as I cup my hands, the angel began to pour gold sovereigns into my hands. And then the angel said to me, now you can pour these sovereigns into any nation you want. And I began to pour them into the northeast of India. And I just kept pouring them in. As I'm pouring them in, little children began to rise up, molten golden children. And then women, and then men. And then what happened after that was the children were given little cups, plastic cups of rice. They turned and gave it to the women, and the women gave it to the men. And then when the children had done that, the children got little sacks of rice. And they were giving it to the women would give it to the men. And then the next thing, I saw this huge sack of rice. And it was as far as the eye could see in every direction. And I saw multitudes of people coming to take rice from this sack. And the next thing, I was back in this room. God began to open up a resource to us for the northeast of India. We began to supply rice to an area that was in famine. And it was economic famine because people weren't buying tea in order to drive the prices up. And we just began to pour it in. That was the first place that I did a crusade, and 40,000 people came to the ground to take rice of God's word. That's what I'm talking about. And when I stood up on the stage with all of these people there, I'd never done anything like that before in my life. I dreamt of doing it, but I'd never done it. And so as I'm standing there, I see the angel that was in Anacortes. It was right at the back of the field where we were. And as I looked, the angel just started to grow. I didn't know angels grew. But this angel, it grew till it covered the whole of the ground where we were gathered. And then I'm looking up as the angel is above me. The angel then reaches down, and in the angel's hands are five pairs of kidneys. And as I looked, he was offering them to me. And then I said, if there's anybody here and you have problems with your kidneys, that you're on dialysis, because that was the only thing I could think of, then you come out. Four people came forward. And you could see they were jaundiced, their eyes were yellow, their face was yellow. And all of them were in serious conditions with kidney disease. And they brought them up onto the platform, and you could see color coming back into them. And they began to run around the place. And then I said, but where's the fifth person? And they said, oh, she's down here. So I go down to where this woman is, and I take hold of her by her hand. I pick her out of a chair. And then everybody around her just goes crazy. They're just going ballistic. And I said, what's the matter? They said, she's paralyzed. I said, well, she doesn't look paralyzed now. And she gets totally healed, and the paralysis goes from the operation that she'd had. Listen, it's easy when angels show up. You don't have to try and work on words of knowledge and all the rest. Everybody thought I was operating in words of knowledge. I was just taking heaven's resources and I was giving them to people. That's all it was about. And I believe that we're moving into a place where God wants to bring us into the heavenly courts of His palace. All that you've been through is to get you so that you can have access into that place. And here, what does he do? He prepares himself, he shaves, changes his clothes, and he comes into the king's palace. And in there, see, God then brings restoration into every area of his life. His brothers come to see him, and the favor of God is upon his life. And when his brothers come to see him, they don't recognize who he is. See, that's what favor does. And that's what the cross does in your life. It changes you. Changes the way that you look. And then there comes a point where it says, and Joseph could not keep himself from his brothers any longer. And he made himself known to them. See, I believe there's people that you're going to start making yourself known to because you know who you are. See, Joseph knew who he was. And in that place, God called him. 13 years of being in the place that he was. And in one night, there was a knock on the door. And they said, Joseph, it's time for you to come. See, 13 years. And it says this of Joseph. By faith, Joseph gave instructions concerning the Exodus, to take his bones, when they left, to take his bones as well. By faith, he saw into the future. See, I believe tonight God's coming knocking. And he's knocking on your door, the place where you are, because he says, tonight, it's time to move on. It's time to come out. And I know there's people here. And you've gone through things. You've gone through being abandoned. You've gone through those times when you've tried to work it all out yourself. It's times when you've gone through jealousy, all of those things. And tonight, God wants you to know that he's brought you through it so that he could give you more. And you thought it was going to take something from you. God was just trying to find a way where he could get so much more to you, so that you could be in a place where you ministered to a nation. See, I believe that this is the year. We've been making these declarations at home. This is the year of God's favor to be over my life. That's a declaration that we're making. That this is the year for Josephs to arise. Are there any Josephs here tonight? This is my new beginning. Anybody here want a new beginning? It's time for me to be fruitful. Are there any people here that want to be fruitful? It's time for me to receive heaven's strategies. Is there anyone here wanting to know heaven's strategies? God is about to release them. I am the key. You are the key to unlocking your future and stepping out of the place where you are and moving into the place where you can receive a fresh mantle of anointing. Stewardship and abundance are going to be the key words of my life and your life in this coming year. Stewardship and abundance are going to be our key words as we come into this new season and into this year of Vav. God is going to establish you so that you can bring resources into nations, and so that you can be the blessing that he always wanted you to be. And tonight, God is going to put a mantle, he's going to put anointing upon you. And listen, if you're here tonight and you need healing, is all you have to do is to walk in the anointing. And God is going to put a mantle of health over your life. As you walk through, just reach up and touch the mantles that are going to be here.
Now,
and as you touch it,
place, servers.
And as you touch that mantle, God is going to put health over you. You're here tonight and you've been struggling even with finances. Let me tell you, God says you're moving out of that place. You're moving out of that place. Tonight, the door of poverty is being unlocked and you're coming into a place of abundance. Somebody in our church just recently had a debt over their lives of £50,000. They reached up, took hold of this new mantle in their lives. Within 1 week, they'd received half of it paid off. Then they received another $5,000 so they could pay some more off. And then they got promotion so that they could begin to pay off the rest, so that within the next 12 months, they're going to be totally debt free. Isn't that good? Listen, just by reaching up and touching a cloth, that's all it is.
Let's bring those mantles right down the center aisles here. If you would just move out of the center aisles, we're going to put the mantles in. And the Spirit of God is here. This is what he's saying to us tonight. There's a new mantle. There's a new mantle of glory.
Yes.
There's a new mantle of river and refreshing. Look at somebody and say, go deeper. There's a new mantle of promise and manifestation over you. Whoa. Feel the Spirit of God here. Now, the way we're going to do this, we're going to come down this aisle here. We're going to come down this aisle here. And as we go out tonight, we're going to come under these mantles. I want, when you go under them, I want you to just reach up and touch them. Now, at times, you're going to have to relieve these that are holding them till we get out of here. But the Spirit of God is here for an impartation. I'm going to ask Trevor to loose that anointing upon us.
So lift up your hands right now. Father, you said that there is a new mantle of anointing for us to walk in. There is a new realm of glory for us to have access to. That you said that you're going to put our faces into our futures. That you're going to release us into a new dimension of influence. That you're going to release us through the anointing to demonstrate the power of heaven on earth. And so we reach up our hands tonight. Are the Josephs arising? Let the Josephs give a shout of praise.
Now, all of you on the web, we're going to bring you under with us as we come.
Yeah.
We're going to decree that you're moving right under with us. Lift your hands out there on the web, wherever you are. Lift your hands, wave them, wave them, wave them. If you have an offering, leave it on the altar. That's where we bring our offerings. We don't take offerings, we bring an offering to the altar. We have an anointing for each one of you, an anointing oil or balm. Receive it and then go out under these mantles. Decree promises being unlocked. Decree the river of blessings overflowing. Decree the glory of God falling on you and the favor of God resting on you. Let's move forward.
Yeah.
Lord, we receive you now.
Yeah.
We exalt you.
Shabarabasa. Father, release the golden oil of your glory over us. Release healings. Put a mantle of health on every person that walks under here. Put in a mantle of abundance upon our lives.
A Father, mantle for increase.
Let the years of famine be over and let us move into a place of abundance. Whoa!
New vision where you've not been able to see promises multiply. The ability to see your promises. Lord, we receive tonight going into 5776, which will cross us into 2016, an anointing to stake claim on our future. Now let James with his new mantle impart to you as you go under. Open your oil and anoint yourself as you go under. Anoint someone else next to you.
Yeah. Oh, we
know who you are.
Call for the soul who's excellent.
We invite all of you back for 7:30. We had the First Assembly of God pastor here from Lake Dallas. We invite you to go over to visit him. Get in place and position yourself for the future. Let the anointing of God fall on you. What stirs up in you, you'll pour out.
All for the soul is excellence. All I require from life, God has given me. I know who I am. We are a chosen generation.
yourself again.
All I require for life, God has given me. I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What He says I am. Where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What He says I am. Where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I'm walking in power.
Yes, I want a new covering.
I get the gold. I live a life of favor. I know who I am. Hey. We are the chosen. We are the chosen generation. God wants to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me. I know who I am. Oh, oh. We are the chosen generation.
Shout your entering in to 5776 covered in a new way.
I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What He says I am. Where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What He says I am, where He says I'm at, I know who I am. I'm walking in power, I'm working miracles, I live a life of favor, I know who I am.
Right in power, down
I'm working miracles, I live a life of favor.
Turn and anoint somebody with the anointing you receive.
All I require for life, God has given me. I know who I am. We are a chosen generation. God wants to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me. I know who I am. I know who God says I am, what He says I am, where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I know who God says I am, what He says I am, where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I know who God says I am, what He says I am, where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I know who God says I am, what He says I am, where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I'm working miracles. I live a life of favor. I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I'm working miracles. I live a life of favor. I know who I am. Oh, 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 oh.
Tomorrow.
I know who I am. Oh, 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 oh,
take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. If you see his glory, I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. If you see his glory, I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. If you see his glory, I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. If you see his glory, I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What he says I am. Where he says I'm at. I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What he says I am. Where he says I'm at. I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I'm working miracles. I live a life of favor. I know who I am.
Look at new favor, new authority.
take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now, you can see it's alright, cause I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now, you can see it's alright,
all of you on the web, when you give tonight, put in there new favor.
I'm walking in power. Working miracles, I live a life of favor. I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I'm working miracles, I live a life of favor. I know who I am. Oh, 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 oh. I know who I am. Oh, 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 oh.
Promotions, favor to overcome. Favor.
says I am, what he says I am, where he says I act. I know who I am, I know who God says I am, what he says I am, where he says I act. I know who I am, I know who God says I am, what he says I am, where he says I act. I know who I am, I know who God says I am, what he says I am, where he says I am. I know who I am,